Cancer detected early has a survival statistic of greater than 98%. That's an absolute lifesaver. If only we can develop a system that can catch cancer early, that's simple, cheap, accurate, and could get translated into the hospitals. My name is Matt Trau. I'm a professor of physical chemistry at the University of Queensland and a senior group leader at the AIBN. My lab is very interested in creating what we call highly innovative nanoscaled sensors that could really give us new eyes on the fundamental machinery of biology and living systems. Those technologies give us new information, particularly about disease mechanisms in cancer, infectious disease, autoimmune systems. Currently, for cancer detection, most cancer detection methods are still rather primitive. They are physical examination, looking for lumps. Other methods are imaging techniques, so for example, mammography, CAT scans, PET scans, ultrasounds. These are getting better, but they're still macroscopic methods. They're not looking for the core machinery that's disrupted in cancer. Cancerous cells, when they die, they basically explode and they release their contents into the bloodstream. So our systems look at specific DNA signatures called epigenetic signatures that are absolutely specific to cancer. And we've discovered recently a universal epigenetic signature for all cancers that can be detected at trace in blood and can catch cancers, we believe, even before a physical examination or an imaging system could catch them. If we're able to detect cancer early through, for example, a blood test or a urine test or a saliva test, it allows us to give information to doctors about what specific medicines that patient needs. This is the area of precision medicine, and it's something that I think is going to be the future of medicine, the ability of giving just the right drug to the right patient at just the right time, I think is a big part of the future and will move us away from the one drug cure all system. In research, you need the space to be able to be, you know, incredibly creative, to try things that absolutely no one has tried before. You need to be able to take a dramatic risk, and that can only be done in the modern environment with philanthropic support. I'd say that the majority of the projects that we currently are running started with philanthropic support. They've allowed us to make that breakthrough leap, and then we can bring more resources into it by other means to support it. And we're so grateful to the individuals and the agencies that have donated to our lab.